Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Chicago Cubs franchise series here in MLB 14, the show. The Cubs are three games out of a playoff spot, or out of first place in the National League Central. The Cincinnati Reds currently lead the division, but the Cardinals just a half game out, the Brewers a game and a half out, and there are the Cubs at three games out. So it is anybody's division still. Cubs hanging in there with their playoff hopes. So we look at the schedule coming up, and it is a three-game series at St. Louis that is next for the Cubs. Chris Archer taking the mound in game one of the series against Joe Kelly. So it looks like a winnable game as far as the pitching matchup, but we go on out to St. Louis for the action. Game one of three coming up from St. Louis. As we see the arch in the background, it is time for Cubs and Cardinals from Busch Stadium. All right, here we go to the ballpark. Looks like a lovely day to get things started here for an NL Central battle. There we see the records. Cubs at 67-67. Yes, that's just a 500 record, but it is keeping them in the division race as of right now. So here we go with our starting lineup. This is what we're going to throw out there against Kelly, and Emilio Bonifacio will lead the game off, hitting 256. Let's see what he can do in the top of the first inning. He works a 3-1 count, and he's able to put that one through out to the outfield, the left field, a base hit, and he is on. So he worked that hitter's count. Now they're worried about him on the base pass, throwing over there, checking him with Starlin Castro at the plate and one out. He's worked a 3-run count, and he's going to get up there and reach this pitch. Right center field gap, and is going to go to the fence. Runner coming around third. That is Bonifacio, and he will score. The throw to third is going to get Castro, so trying for a triple. He will get thrown out, but the run does come home, making it 1-0 Cubs. You see a replay of the relay throw that, oh, that was close. I don't know. He was almost in there, but he is called out. So 1-0 into the bottom of the first, and a runner at third, chance to tie this up, but the ground ball out will get Archer out of the bottom of the first inning with no score against him. The Cubs continue to lead 1-0. We fast forward into the bottom of the third inning, 1-2 count, and this is the opposing pitcher, Kelly, at the plate. He is going to strike out, so Archer takes him out, and he has one down in the inning. So far, so good for Chris Archer. 3-2 count with one out, and the next pitch will be strike three to Jay. Oh, wow. My release point wasn't where I wanted it on that pitch, but it still works out just fine as he gets the call. Now with two outs, this is going to be a grounder to third base. Mike Olt will throw over and get the third out of the inning. So the Cubs, so far through three, are holding the Cardinals down and frustrating Matt Carpenter and company. Can the Bats respond and get some more runs in this game? Well, let's find out. Top of the fifth inning, another 3-1 count, this time to Jorge Soler, and he cranks this ball in the gap to right center field. It is a double. Is he going to go three? He thought about it, but he puts on the brakes at second. This is another good scoring chance for Chicago as Soler is able to get a double to the opposite field gap. So will anyone be able to bring him home? Let's find out in this inning here. Standing at second, one out. And this is Wellington Castillo, the catcher, at the plate. Kind of fist this one out to center field. It's going to drop in front of the center fielder for a base hit. Runner coming around is Soler, and he is just ahead of the tag. He kicks the ball away from the catcher's glove. Either way, he is safe. 2-0 Cubs after that RBI base hit. Now runners at third base for the Cardinals. Another chance for them to score. Another ground ball out that gets Chris Archer out of an inning. So despite base runners, or base runner in this case, it is not happening for the Cardinals through five innings. We go to the top of the sixth, and Anthony Rizzo is going to fight off a base hit to center field. Runner coming around third, and another chance to score. This is cut off, and it is 3-0 Cubs. So not hitting the long balls today, but they are putting together some hits. Bonifacio scores yet again, this time on an Anthony Rizzo base knock, and the Cubs lead 3-0. Now, we've had some bullpen issues at various points in the season. Chris Archer knows that. He wants to go as long as he can here. He gets Molina to pop foul. There's Rizzo over on the grass making the catch and ending the sixth inning. So Archer's through six, but he wants to give him a good seven strong at least, putting this to a good position for the bullpen. But he has a walk right here, and he is getting up there in his pitch count, 93 pitches now. And you got to think about the bullpen in this case. You got runners at second and third now with nobody out. That is going to be a ground ball to short. It will be the first out, but it will also be the first run for the Cardinals on the day, an RBI ground out. And the Cardinals have finally pushed one across, but they want more than that. Runner at second with one out now, and this is going to be in foul territory. Will there be room for Rizzo to make a catch? Yes, he catches it over by the tarp there, and there now are two away in the inning, one out away from escaping the seventh inning. 2-2 count, two outs, and oh, it's a base hit to center field. Runner coming around third base to score. The throw is not in time, and they've got another run. Alexi Ramirez comes home to score and makes it 3-2. Cardinals are right on the doorstep now. Archer surrenders this base hit to center field, and it might be time to take him out. So on comes Blake Parker with 3-2 count and two outs, and oh, what a catch in right field. Thought that might drop, but Soler makes the catch and ends the inning. So the Cardinals get two runs, but they cannot come all the way back quite yet. 3-2 in the bottom of the eighth, and this is going to be a dribbler to short, and it should be out number three. It is. The Cubs will head to the ninth inning with the lead. Can they add any insurance on with their 4, 5, and 6 hitters coming up in the top of the ninth? Let's see right here. Ruggiano is going to ground to third base, and he is thrown out. Justin Ruggiano was just traded the other day in real life. Lots of things happening with the Cubs roster. We'll touch on that before this video is over, but Ryan Madsen coming in to try to get his 37th save of the season. Wow. When he was our plan B early on in the year, when things weren't going on very well at the closer spot, who would have thought we'd get this kind of production out of Ryan Madsen? But we are getting exactly that. The heater will strike out Alan Craig, and now with two outs, Pete Cosma is going to be the pinch hitter trying to get the Cardinals back into this game. 3-2 count. Oh, he loses him with the fastball. It was close, but he will not get the call. High and tight in the zone. So Madsen now has to work with the runner on base, and they will get Elliot Johnson off the bench to pinch run to try to get some speed out there. So a 2-1 count, two outs, and this will be dribbled to Rizzo. He goes over to the base himself, and the Cubs win 3-2, and they get a game closer, at least to the Cardinals. We'll have to see how the Reds did and how everyone else did in the division, but they take game one from St. Louis here and are celebrating here on their rivals field tonight as Ryan Madsen closes down another game, and it is a tight one, 3-2. Chris Archer gets the win, and that one feels good as they continue to be in the hunt. Chris Archer is your player of the game for that start and for the victory. Now, we go to the standings and see what is up. Well, first of all, we are looking at the calendar. We see we get that win in game one of the series, and that puts us two games behind the pack. You see the Cardinals a half game out now, the Brewers a half game out. Things getting more and more interesting by the day, and they go ahead and sweep St. Louis, a road sweep. How about that? And now they've got a series against Milwaukee that they'll take 2 of 3. So those were two big series back-to-back. We need to see where that puts us in the standings right now, as that puts us just a game off the pack. Look at how tight things are. The Brewers and the Reds tied atop the National League Central with the Cubs just a game behind. The Cardinals a game behind that at two games out. Everything getting extremely tight here, and now you've got a sweep of the Pittsburgh Pirates as well. The Cubs are playing excellent baseball starting off the final month of the year. Now, with a 3-game set in Toronto, the Cubs are actually in first place by a game over the Reds and Cardinals. Cubs in first place in September. Holy smokes, could we be going to reverse a curse? That's what John Lester says he's going to go do in real life. We'll have to see if this version of the Cubs can get into the playoffs, and then who knows what will happen from there. More Cubs baseball coming up next.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.